Challenge accepted!
Why?
Why?
It's Jordy here for Cinecom.net, and welcome back to another exciting episode of Copycat Friday, a weekly series where we figure out how to recreate a film, music video, or any other trend. And a little time ago, we took the Invisible Box Challenge to a whole new level, and today we'll be focusing on the next stupid internet hype, which is the Gucci Challenge. Little background for those who don't know what I'm talking about. The fashion brand Gucci recently did a show in Milan showing the new fashion trends. And these fashion shows are very conceptual, so you would often see quite weird things in there. Like models with a third eye or... yeah, I don't even know how to describe this. And one of the models was strangely enough holding her own head. And you guys were saying that the future looked bad when we talked about vertical video. I guess holding your head as a fashion accessory is a little bit worse. The model was, of course, holding a custom-built doll hat, and we're going to do it all digital with some editing tricks inside After Effects. But before we do that, let's first have a look at the easiest way to pull off the Gucci challenge.
Ta-da!
A quick shout out to Videoblocks, who are sponsoring today's episode, and they're not only sponsoring, but they have also helped us on so many projects because we've been using Videoblocks for more than a year now. And on Videoblocks, you can find things like stock footage, logo reveals, After Effects templates, video effects, backgrounds, and tons more. And what's cool about their service is that you can actually get access to a library with unlimited downloads for an entire year for one fixed price. And on top of that, you can even get a huge discount by following the first link in the description below. So of course we want to hold our own heads, because else the trick isn't so spectacular. So the first thing we did was building our own little fashion catwalk. So behind me we have a strong backlight, which is making sure that we have this halo around the subject, which is always cool. And over here we've got the LS1 from Aperture, that is an LED panel, and we have this soft filter over it, which is making sure that we have some kind of more of a fill lighting going on here on our scene. And then over here we've got a key light, which is going to be stronger than the fill light, and that way we have some kind of a contrast over the face, but we want to keep it very soft to get good skin tones. And we are using the Stella 5000s for that. We made a video about that this Tuesday. You can find a link to it in the description below as well. Very cool lights. It works with a remote. There we go, and now we have got a very big light source, which is soft and very powerful. So there are a couple of ways to pull off the trick. One is where you just make the pose as it seems like you're holding your own head. The other is where you hold a ball to have a more natural pose of holding something. But here we did find some problems where the ball was wider than a face. So the best thing that you could do is either holding a smaller ball or an actual doll head. Now since Janik's hand comes in front of the doll's head, we wrapped it with a simple green paper that we printed out and attached it where his fingers overlapped. Now this will make some things go easier inside post-production later on. Next, you make your catwalk move and try to keep the doll head, or the ball if you're using that, as straight as possible. And then comes the second shot, and here we just have Janik standing in front of a green screen because we only need his head. And to make it even easier for us, we also covered his body with a green cloth. And this doesn't have to be a real green screen, you can also just use a green t-shirt or any other fabric that you can find. His head needed to be super still though, so he leaned on a light stand.
Ta-da!
So once you got your shots, we're going to open up Adobe After Effects, and this is because we're going to have to track the motion of the first shot. You can do that with the built-in tracker. Make sure that you're going to track the position, rotation, and the scale as Janik is moving forward. And if you want to see an in-depth tutorial on how to use the motion tracker inside After Effects, then just click any card up there or locate a link in your description below. The next step is the head, which you want to isolate with a mask and then take out the green with the key light effects. You can reposition and scale it, and once it sits in place, simply link it to the tracking data we did prior, and your head should already move with the movement of your main character. The hand should come in front of the head, so we're going to duplicate the walking shot to the upper layer and draw a mask around the hand. Then also apply the key light effect to here to remove the green paper. And since you're moving forward, the mask here probably needs to follow as well. But that goes very easy, as you can just right-click on the mask and hit track mask. So those who don't know it yet, this right here is Lorenzo, and he's doing an internship here at Cinecom, and he's been loving it so far. He loves me, he loves Janik also a little bit, not as much as me, he just loves Cinecom. Isn't that right, Lorenzo?
I just want my points. Please give me my points.
and it's already starting to look great, but what can't be missed are some shadows. So I'm going to add a black solid into the composition underneath the hand layer and draw a mask on that solid, roughly the same shape as his fingers. And then you can tweak the feather of that mask a little more and probably the opacity as well. And that way you have created a fake shadow coming from his hand. And don't forget to link that shadow as well to the tracking data. And as the final touch, I'm also going to add a lighting change into Janik's head, because in the catwalk shot, he walks from a darker spot to a brighter spot. And because we filmed Janik's head on the green screen, in the bright spot, it doesn't match so well in the beginning. But no worries, simply create a solid again, and this time I'm going to choose a dark red color, as that fits better with his skin tones. Draw a mask on that solid on the bright part of his face. Again, play around with the feather and opacity to match the exposure. And finally, link this solid as well to the tracker. Now, this exposure changes, so create a keyframe for the opacity and animate it so that the opacity decreases over time and illuminates his face more and more. And if everything went well, you can now hold your own head and send that video in to Gucci. Who knows, maybe next year you're also running around under catwalk. But be prepared for the 2019 fashion trends. It might get even scarier. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you are on Facebook though, make sure to follow us, as we've just created a new schedule, and every day you can learn something new or get entertained with a fun video related post, because that will help us all to staying creative.
Thank you.